Hello, welcome back. I will continue talking about books about presidents. And just so we know, with great power comes great responsibility. This truth may be best represented by the U.S. presidency. I just wanted to let you know, we do have president of the 90s, Bill Clinton. Books about Bill Clinton. See, this is one. This is another one. And I think I have another one. Okay, no, we only have these two for now. But, and then I also have our 44th president, Barack Obama. And we have three biographies of George W. Bush. These three are here. And George W. Bush was our 43rd president, okay? So I am in the process of adding books of our current 45th president, Donald J. Trump. Remember, if you need these biographies for a book report, or you just want to read for leisure and find out about their lives, they're here in the library, okay? And then a little bit about some of these books. And again, I will read off from the back of the book so that you have an idea what these are about. I'm just gonna read this one on George W. Bush. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about him. It says, George W. Bush was born into a family that believed in public service through politics. His grandfather served as senator from Connecticut. His father served as the 41st president of the United States. His brother had served as governor of Florida, and George W. served as governor of Texas before being elected the nation's 43rd president. Having gained the office in one of the most controversial elections in the history of the United States, President Bush was on certain ground in the early months of his presidency. But the terrorist attack on the United States in September of 2001 has been a vital providing ground. President Bush seems to have learned, as have his fellow Americans, that America's interests and the interests of the world community go hand in hand. So that's a little bit about this book. And we have three, okay? And then we have Barack Obama. And Barack Obama was our 44th president. Right? It says, Barack Obama's meteoric rise to the presidency began with his speech at the Democratic National Convention in 2004. This same year, he went from being an Illinois state senator to being elected a United States senator. Just over 2 years later, he declared his candidacy for president. By November 2008, he was elected president. In this biography, you, the reader, will find out about Obama's life, from his childhood in Hawaii to his rise to becoming our 44th president, the first African-American commander-in-chief in the history of the United States, all right? And this is Barack Obama. And then we have three on Bill Clinton, it's two on Bill Clinton that I have here in the library for you. And a little bit about this book right here. It says, in 1963, 16-year-old Bill Clinton shook hands with President John F. Kennedy while visiting the White House as a boy state representative from Arkansas. 30 years later, he would once again visit the White House, this time as the 42nd president of the United States. But the road to the White House was not an easy one, and Bill Clinton had many obstacles to overcome on the way. His history is one of hope and perseverance and shows how one person can make a difference. So we have these three presidents that are not part of the Encyclopedia of Presidents. And that's why I wanted to continue and do this video so that you know that we do have these three other presidents, because I know when I talked about the Encyclopedia of Presidents, I don't have them in the library, and they're not part of this one. But just wanted to let you know that we do have all the presidents that have served the United States in the last years and last decades. So as I always tell you, you're more than welcome to come and visit us throughout the day, anytime you have a break, during your 5-minute passing time, during your breakfast time, lunch, after school. And if it's during school time, during school class, just don't forget to come in and bring a pass, as always. Thank you, and I'll see you throughout the day.